This French microbiologist remained largely unknown to the scientific world until recently. She had to move between 9 different institutes before she was finally offered a position with proper support and funding. Today she is a Nobel laureate. She is also the director of the prestigious institute, Max Planck Institute for Infection Biology in Berlin. Emmanuelle Charpentier was born in France in 1968. Her father was a park manager and her mother worked in psychiatry. Both of her parents were very supportive of her and encouraged her independence. Growing up, her parents encouraged Charpentier to explore and choose what she loves. But how do you choose when you have so many options and you love all of them? She loves pure science and mathematics. But she also loves human science such as psychology, sociology and philosophy. In the end she chooses science. But why did she choose science and not psychology? Well, her father used to teach her the names of various plants in Latin. Maybe this influenced her to study pure science. That's what Charpentier believed when she was asked why she chose science. When she was around 12 years old, she promised to her family that she would study at Pierre and Marie Curie University when she grows older. She did not break her promise. Charpentier did her undergraduate as well as her graduate studies from Pierre and Marie Curie University. She went to Pasteur Institute for her PhD. She loved being a scientist. Doing research is what she loves. She also enjoys the solitude while doing research. Charpentier is also a person with strong will. Roger Novak, a postdoctoral researcher who worked with her, said, "She is like a dog with a bone, tenacious." During her PhD, at Pasteur Institute, Charpentier was a typical French girl. She thought that after a short excursion, she would work the rest of her life at home. But maybe she was different after all. After her PhD, she applied for a number of labs in US and got many offers. She chooses a lab in Rockefeller University in New York, to work on the pathogen Streptococcus pneumoniae. She worked in genetic engineering. After her postdoctoral work, Charpentier he returned to Europe. First thing she wants was independence. So, she had to build her own lab, from the scratch. She has spent years moving in 9 different institutes in 5 different countries over the past 20 years. Moving to different institute was not easy for her. Charpentier started working on CRISPR in the early 2000s. It was niche topic at the time. Only few microbiologists were studying them. Today, she is an expert in CRISPR field. But back then, she was considered an outsider in the CRISPR community. She made a collaboration with Jörg Vogel, a group leader at the Max Planck Institute for Infection Biology who has expertise on RNA genome. In 2008, Vogel had sequenced all the small RNA produced by the bacterium, Streptococcus pyogene. When they saw the sequencing results, they noticed something new in the sequence. There are huge number of a particular RNA sequence. They named this RNA, transactivating CRISPR RNA or tracer RNA. But they don't know the function of this RNA. At that time, only one RNA molecule, CRISPR RNA, was known to work in the CRISPR system. A bioinformatics software at Charpentier's lab predicted that these tracer RNA is located near the CRISPR locus. This suggested that tracer RNA may likely be a part of the CRISPR system. Charpentier wants to understand how this tracer RNA work along with Cas protein and CRISPR RNA. But nobody in Charpentier's lab wants to study them. A new master student at last volunteered to do the experiment. Her name is Elitz Delcheva. Delcheva started working on the experiment. In the summer 2009, Delcheva got the research done. She elucidated how tracer RNA and CRISPR RNA work together. They submitted their manuscript to Nature. After submission, Charpentier presented the work at the CRISPR meeting in the Netherlands. Her work became the highlight of the meeting. Nobody expects her as she was not even an expert on CRISPR at the time. In 2011, she met Jennifer Doudna at a microbiology conference in San Juan, Puerto Rico. Jennifer Doudna was already a recognized structural biologist at the time. Doudna was trying to understand how CRISPR-Cas9 protein works from the structural point of view. When they met for the first time, they instantly got along well and they decided to collaborate. Their collaboration led to another key discovery, how Cas9 cleaved DNA. Their paper was published in Science in 2012. From then, CRISPR has revolutionized the field of biology. Since 2015, Charpentier is the director of the prestigious institute, Max Planck Institute for Infection Biology in Berlin. In 2018, she also founded an independent research institute, the Max Planck Unit for the Science of Pathogens. She founded a biotech company called CRISPR Therapeutics in 2018. The company is working on cystic fibrosis and sickle cell disease, and certain types of eye disease. Today the company is valued $2.5 billion. They have their office in US, Switzerland and UK. She is also the founder of an intellectual property firm, ERS Genomics. In August 2020, she along with Jennifer Doudna won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for the discovery of the genome editing tool, CRISPR-Cas. They became the first female duo to win a Nobel Prize. They continue to inspire millions of girls worldwide. If you like the video, please subscribe.